are the seventh son of a seventh son. Since the beginning of time, we have protected mankind. We fight the darkness wherever it hides. Show me what you are!
The movie is an adaptation of a book. And was it a tough sell, or you got interested immediately when it presented to you?
Well, it was a very fast process between me not being interested and being interested. I read it and they were like, a fantasy film set in the world of... And I was like, ugh, I've done fantasy films before. Yeah. The role of the spook would be played by Jeff Bridges. I'm in. Done.
So it's Jeff Bridges.
Well, he was the first thing. Okay. Because he is just one of my heroes. He's iconic. He's, you know, he's a brilliant dramatic actor, a brilliant comedic actor. He's so charismatic and you know, mysterious and all, you know, he's got it all. So he was someone that I wanted to kind of obviously work with, and all of the scenes were with him. And then I read the script and I read a couple of the books, you know, I think about five in the end of the series that it's sort of loosely based on. And I you know, you fall in love with this world and the characters, and you go on these journeys with them. And, you know, you can't, it's irresistible.
See, in the movie, you play Tom Ward. Mm. And what do you find is the most challenging part of playing the character?
I mean, you know, the physical stuff is fun for me, you know, in terms of learning the star fighting and the diving and the, you know, all the kind of various stunts that you get in terms of the action. The most difficult part, I think, was in the book, the character's 13, and so a child is a child is a child, you know, and you're kind of seeing the world through his eyes. But when he's an adult, you've got to work out what kind of a man he is. So that was the kind of biggest challenge, because there was some debate as to whether he should be kind of more gritty and tough or whether he should be kind of warm and sweet. And I think, obviously, in the end, everyone's a balance of those things.
Was it the first time you meet Julianne Moore when you are on set?
Yeah, I didn't really even get to spend very much time with her, because our characters don't interact that much, so I didn't really get to act with her, which I would love to do. But she is just so immediately warm and engaging and charming and sweet, and you want to be around her. She's like the sun. You just want to be near her.
And you mentioned about Jeff Bridges. During his free time, he liked to do a lot of stuff and cracking jokes and things like that. And when on set, how could you resist break into laughter or, you know, concentrate on the acting part?
Well, he takes it very seriously. He asks a lot of questions and he takes it very, very, very seriously. I mean, he's a prolific, you know, artist in terms of drawing and photography and all this stuff, and he's always doing all of them at the same time when he's thinking about these kind of approaches. But he wants each scene to be the best version of the scene it can be, and he really, really thinks about it. So, you know, you're not kind of goofing around, you know, too much. But then when you're allowed to kind of improvise a little bit and try and come up with some fun stuff, then it's kind of okay to kind of be giggling. But he's just so interesting.
If you could say something to your character, Tom Ward, what would it be?
Trust your instincts.
Trust your instinct. Why do you say so?
Sorry?
Why would you say so?
I think because he's quite hesitant, and he's getting advice from so many angles. And in the end, what you first think of is usually the right path.
And tomorrow is Jeff's birthday.
It is.
Would you draw something for him?
Would I draw something for him?
Yes, because he draws a lot of things. Right.
He draws a lot of things for me.
You mentioned just now in a press conference.
Are you going to see him tomorrow?
No, I'm just going to show and let everybody else see.
Oh, no, that's terrible. I'm such a bad drawer. This is awful putting me on the spot. Oh, see, now we're going to see like how brilliant he is compared with... Oh, no, this is...
That's okay. It's an art. It's a form of art.
You can't see that. We're just going to say...
It's a form of art.
We're going to say this.
Right.
That's not a drawing. I chickened out. I chickened out. It was so bad.
That's okay. I think that's wonderful as well.
You're such a liar.
That's all. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Ben.
Thanks.